Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, as you all are aware that we are revising the syllabus of term 1. Today in this series of revision, we are going to revise poem 1, My Mother at 66. So this time in revision, I have decided to make you write down. So let's begin. Paraphrase. Stanza 1. Driving from my parents' home to Kochi Airport last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me. Doors open mouth, her face Asian like that of a corpse. So this is the stanza for which we are going to write down paraphrase. It was last Friday morning. It was last Friday morning when the poetess Kamala Das was driving from her parents' home to Kochi Airport. From her parents' home to Kochi Airport. Sorry. Her mother was sitting by her side. The poetess mother. Her mother was sitting by her side. Her mother was sitting by her side in a car. In a car. She was dozing and her mouth was open. She was dozing. Her face was colorless and lifeless. Her face was colorless and lifeless. Her face was colorless and lifeless. Like that of a corpse. Like that of a like that of a corpse. But she was alive. In the first stanza, the poet says, "It was last Friday morning when the poet was driving from her parents' home to Cochin Airport. Her mother was sitting by her side in a car. She was dozing, and her mother was her mouth was open. Her face was colorless and lifeless, like that of a corpse. But she was alive." So let me repeat and write down the paraphrase of stanza 2. Paraphrase 2. The poetess was deeply pained. Let me read out the stanza 2. "And realized with pain that she thought away and looked, but soon put that thought away and looked out at young trees sprinting, the merry children spilling out of their homes." The poetess was deeply pained to see her mother like that. To see her mother like that. She felt that her mother might have lost somewhere else. She, the poetess, thought that her mother might have lost somewhere. Her mother might have lost somewhere else in her own thoughts of easy. In her old thoughts of easing, she looked at her mother again. She looked at her mother again. She looked at her mother again. But very soon turned her mind away from her. But very soon turned her mind away from her. She looked at the outside world. She looked at the outside world. There she saw the young trees running. There she saw young trees running. Young trees running past them. She looked at the merry children coming out. She looked at the merry children coming out. She looked at the merry children coming out of their homes. Coming out of their homes. Then she felt life and vitality in the outside world. In the outside world. She realized the natural process of aging as well as the happy world. She realized the natural process of aging and happiness in the outside of world and happy world. Okay. In the second stanza, the poetess was deeply pained to see her mother in that condition. The poetess felt that her mother might have lost somewhere else in her own thoughts of aging. She looked at her. The poetess looked at her mother again, but very soon turned her mind from her. She looked at the outside world. There she saw young trees running past them. She looked at the merry children coming out of their homes. Then she felt life and vitality in the outside world. She realized the natural process of aging as well as the happy life. Now, third stanza. Paraphrase 3. But after the airport security check, standing a few yards away, I looked again at her worn pale, as late as a late winter's moon, and felt that old familiar ache, my childhood's fear. At the airport, they had a security check. But her mother was standing a few yards away. But her mother was standing a few yards away. The poetess looked at her mother again. Poetess looked at her mother again. She looked pale and colorless, like the moon of late winter. She looked pale and colorless, like the moon of late winter. She looked pale and colorless, like the moon of late winter. Like the moon of late winter. In the midst of these, in the midst of these, in the midst of these, the poetess felt her old childhood's fame. The poetess felt her old, the poetess felt her childhood's pain. The poetess felt her childhood's pain in her heart, in her heart. So what was her childhood pain of losing her mother? It was that time when aging never spared anyone. It was death were inevitable. Both aging and death were inevitable. Okay, so at the airport they had a security check, but her mother was standing a few yards away. The poetess looked at her mother again. She looked pale and colorless, like the moon of late winter. In the midst of these, the poetess felt her childhood's pain in her heart. It was that time when aging spared no one. Both aging and death were inevitable. Okay, dear students. So, the last stanza will be done in the next video lesson. So it's all about this video lesson. I hope this is the third time when we are revising the poem, and now I am making you write line by line explanation so that you can understand each and every question based on this poem, as in term 1 MCQs will be there. So that is why we need to read each and every chapter deeply. Thank you for watching. See you tomorrow.